Hi, welcome back to a new sketchbook tour. I love filming these videos. It's always very, very exciting to fill up a new sketchbook. It's quite the accomplishment. So this is the sixth sketchbook that I've now completed. It is a Strathmore mixed media. I am aware that this is spelled wrong. It's kind of like a running joke now between me and my friends that I can't spell things right. And I think I just want to like progressively worsen the spelling over time. So I technically started this sketchbook in December of 2020. At the time I was working in a lot of different sketchbooks, so there's a lot of kind of old stuff mixing with the new stuff, but I will explain all of the details. So I used this front page as kind of like a palette while I was painting. And over here I just had a couple of prompts that I made up for myself. When I was going through a little bit of an art block, I didn't know what I wanted to draw, and I just tried to give myself a little bit of help and guidance. I ended up only doing like two of them. And then I ended up coming back to my sketchbook and like kind of hunkering down in this one in June of 2020. So this was an attempt to conquer my art block that I had over here with doing blobs and then just trying my best to fill the blobs with things. I came back and just tried to do some filler here, which like this was kind of the new color palette that I've been really loving lately. I ended up painting over some journaling that I had done. These two things I painted in 2020, but everything else in the green was done in 2021. And actually, this is the first initial sketch of my Ding Dong sticker. He is my brand new sticker that is now available in my Etsy store if you would like to check it out. This guy, I absolutely adore him. I just was mindlessly doodling, and that is what came of it. There's just a lot of really random guys here, but then I have this, which is a depiction of me watching the Great British Baking Show. And I was just kind of slumped on the couch, but having the greatest time of my life. I love this color scheme that I had going on. It's so cute. And this is just a little thing that I made when I was in my fields. And here we've got a little girl. I really liked her when I had done her. Here we've got a couple different, just kind of experimenting with things, and I love this little guy here, he's so silly. Then over here, I remember that I did this frog in 2020 and this, and then I had like a couple different faces that I drew, but I didn't really like it, and so I kind of painted over it in 2021 and went back in with a little bit more of my current style, drawing some houses and some skellies. And this is a mixture of 20 and 2021 art. The faces were 2020, and these kind of here were my newer little boys, but it's kind of fun to see it like all together, very different styles of art. I can't figure out a good way to get my plant in here. I want him in there, but he can't be covering up my art. Maybe if I move this closer, there we go. So here I was just doing some paint blobs and filling them in however I felt like it. I called this guy Lumpy Space Prince because he reminded me of LSP from Adventure Time, but as a guy. And here I was experimenting with some different color palettes and color schemes. This all is from 2020 because I kind of like it, you know, how it is. I really like this girl right here. She's very cute. Then we've got a little bit more little doodly faces. And then over here, this is when I got my gouache and I was just kind of playing around a little bit. And this is actually also a sticker that's available in my Etsy store. I loved him at the time, just a very cute little clown boy. We got some froggies. And this is actually the initial sketch for my birthday boy frog. And he is now the proud mascot on my business card. And he is also a sticker available in my Etsy shop. And here I was doing some art studies. I had gone to the library and gotten a couple different books on different artists, and I was just doing some studies of them. This is a little thing I had put in just to cover up something. I honestly don't remember what's on the back of this, but just like some product design ideas that I'm thinking of messing around with. And then here we have the initial sketch for my skull mood board, which is honestly what really got the ball rolling on me opening my Etsy, which is so exciting. I have such a like sentimental attachment to these guys, and this is the very first print of my Etsy store, and I was really proud of it. And I also went ahead and got the individual skulls printed. So if you identify with any of the skulls and you just wanted to pick up one of the stickers, they're available individually, or you could get them at a discounted rate in my little bundle. I really like this little guy here, this little best pal frame. Then this was, I think, some Inktober stuff for like egg. Here I was just kind of covering up a little bit of things that I didn't like anymore. But this little sketch I'm obsessed with. Like, I don't know why, I just really like it. Just a little bit more doodles. This guy is so cute. Here it was officially 2021, so now we're like starting to get into things that are more my style now, or more current, I should say. And it's just a lot of doodling. This guy, I relate to him a lot. And this guy in his little nighty, he's pretty cute too. I love this little guy here in his little cowboy boots and his hat. And I love this. I was kind of playing around with it and trying to like figure out how to do it. I think I want to come back to that one because I love that concept so much. Here was me messing around a little bit more, but I'm still not happy with it. Just some more doodles, and I write a lot of really random things in here that don't really make sense. Just a lot of doodles, really. I mean, this is a sketchbook. This was a reel, actually, that I put on my Instagram. So if you want to follow me there, sometimes I do little process videos. Now, this spread is my absolute favorite spread. I loved the colors. I think this is when I had gotten new colored pencils and I started really messing around with like primary colors, but like they're pastel, and I just felt so much more comfortable and confident, and everything just looks so much more fun with color. And so we've got some wizards and cherries. Such a cute little spread, so colorful. So this spread was on February 9th of 2021, and just lots of little doodly boys. And then this is a video that's up on my channel where I let my tarot card determine what I'm gonna draw. And it was the Five of Wands, and I was just sketching out ideas. And if you want to check out that video, it'll be over here. This, I remember I was on vacation in Florida with my two best friends, and we were doing a puzzle, and I remember I was so uninspired in art block and just like not feeling it. And I just like hated everything that I was doing, which, you know, was kind of sad. But then over here, we've got a lot of fun stuff going on. So this is now March. We've got some cute little houses, some cool girls. I love her. And a little queen. I really like this spread. It's really cute. This was like some ideas for products that I'm designing. And this is my initial sketch right here for actually a new print that's gonna be coming to my shop very soon, so keep an eye out for that. There's a lot of really exciting things happening, and I'm planning a little shop update, so stay tuned. And it was just kind of like a lot of planning. I had so many ideas like flowing through my brain all at once, and I was so busy, and I could not, like, I just didn't have time to like do everything, and I had to be able to jot everything down really quickly, which is, you know, essentially a sketchbook. And I was starting my keychains and like planning how I wanted to paint them. I ended up making these two dudes, which I love. They kind of remind me of Bert and Ernie. They're just so cute. The lighting is kind of starting to change. I think the sun's gonna be setting soon. Here's a little weird doodle that I did. Lots of weird stuff going on. Then this is when I was watching the Winx Club show, but not the cartoon. I can't remember what it's called right now, but it's like the live action show that's based around the Winx Club. And I was watching that with my sister and my little cousin. And so we were just all drawing and wanted to design ourselves as fairies. This right here, I was really, really proud of. I spent a lot of time like really trying to capture the likeness of the reference that I was using. It took me so long, but I was just like sitting outside in my backyard and just going at it. And I think that it turned out really good. I want to paint it eventually, but I think I'm like so scared because I don't want to ruin it. But I think once my skill improves just a little bit more and I'm not so afraid, I'll get around to that. This was done the same day, and she is very cute as well. Here I was planning products and things that hopefully maybe I'll get around to soon. I don't know, life has been so hectic and things, and sometimes I'll have an idea and think it's amazing, and then 3 minutes later, I'm like, what? I don't know if any of you, when you were kids, would go like, uppie, to your parents when you wanted to get picked up. I just think that it's adorable, and I thought of it. It just like crossed my mind one day, and I was like, uppie, uppie. I specifically remember doing this. I had zero fear whatsoever. Like, I remember I just sat down and I was like, I'm just gonna draw for the sake of literally just having fun and winding down. This one especially turned out like really nicely. I really like that one. Here I was hanging out with my friends and I had this idea. It's called the veggie cuts, and they're different kinds of hair cuts, but vegetables. So we've got carrot curls, broccoli buns. This is just a guy with an onion on his head. A ginger, the mushroom mullet, and the broccoli bob. I was having so much fun with that. I think that would be fun to further explore in my sketchbook now. This is a little self-portrait of me. One night with my friends, we had a little soiree, and we all wore gowns, and I was wearing a beret, and I felt like I was living my French artist fantasy. It was so much fun, and I felt so confident, and so I just drew myself. I think it turned out really cute. I don't know why. I love him. I wish he wasn't so small. That's when I wrote that. I said, why is everything so small? Because whenever I draw small, I think they're so cute. But then, like, it's impossible to, like, I don't know, it's just so small. Like, what am I gonna do with that? Oh, that's the end. Yeah. We have here, I want to do something with this too. We have fail as much as possible. That is my ending words to you, which is, it's really important to fail because that is how you learn. I hope that you enjoyed going through my sketchbook with me. It's always good to look back, like I said earlier. If you would like to subscribe to my channel, that would be super fun. Yeah, I will see you guys very soon in my next video. Bye.